Right, what's up guys? Kaise ho? Alone, I hope everyone is doing great. As you guys know, recently we went for this early morning ride and that day I had an opportunity to ride this beautiful Duke 790 and here are my inputs. So just watch this real-time review and come back. I'll be giving my inputs later after I spoke to my friends, Rohit, Srujan, everyone rode it. We discussed about the bike and we all had something really interesting to say about this bike. Watch it and come back. We'll talk.
అదెక్కినాకేది చిన్నగా ఉంది. దట్స్ అన్ ఇన్సేన్ ఎగ్జాస్ట్ నాట్ యార్ ఇట్స్ గుడ్ ఇట్స్ క్రేజీ యా యా క్రేజీ ఓ నైస్ నైస్ లెట్స్ టేక్ అ స్పిన్ అండ్ కమ్ అరే ఇట్ ఇస్ హార్డ్ టు మూవ్ Unfortunately, I am in a wrong road for this bike. Let me go on to the highway. That is a state highway. Oh man, I can feel every bump, every small stone. Yeah, this is the first time I'm riding a 790 Duke. I rode it before, but that was also like a very small spin. I can already feel the power in it. I mean, it's in second gear, and if I leave the clutch, it's trying to pull itself. It's like hidden torque inside. Chalo, we are on the state highway. Let me see. Was this bike got ready, guys? First gear. Whoa. Fourth gear and look at the pull. We don't have much guards here where I can lean the bike and do all that stuff. It's raw, man. It is really raw. Just insane. I think this is a twin cylinder 790 twin. Look at the sound, yaar. Listen to this exhaust. Shit. I think I can compare this to the street triple. If you ask me which one is better, because I've ridden both state triple, though we have it since the last 2 years, almost 3 years now. Okay, so in the rev range 3000 till 4000 there is no crazy torque, at least in the fourth gear, but after that I can feel weights jumping. See this? Yeah. Actually from 5000 rpm I can feel the pull. The best thing I like about the bike right now is the first impression, the position is really good for a street bike. Shit, man. Exhaust note is A-class. Touring, obviously you can't do. Let me take a U-turn here. I even forgot which lane I have to take back. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Definitely gonna do a wheelie. It's in street mode right now. Whoa. Okay, it's in, I think it's an anti-wheelie mode, something like that. Look at the pull, yaar. Second. Okay, comparing this to the street triple, you have a lot of raw power in this, alright? That is a little bit tuned up, so everything is very linear and nice. Isme, the power output is like very raw. Yeah, in simple terms, it's very raw. And you can feel vibrations obviously in your handlebar and foot pegs. That's because street triple has a triple cylinder. This is a twin. That's expected. But if you want that very racy feeling, the sound and all, obviously street triple is definitely better. Seat is definitely hard. It's like a pan. But yeah man, this can fly. If you're looking for a street bike, I mean right now we don't get the 790. The 890 is coming. soon. And I heard very good reviews about that as well. Power is a little bit linear, it seems. Not like this erratic. But yeah, if you're interested in a street bike, street fighter, I think the Duke 790, right now 890, is really, really good. You can consider this. But definitely take a test ride of the RS Street Triple and this one back to back. I would consider the Street Triple for my liking because you get a little bit of more premium. Oh shit. Oh, be careful in these things. Oh. Yeah, suspension is super hard. But this can fly here. I have to take a ride somewhere here, right? Now there I see my friends. And it pops so much air. I mean the popping sound. Look at that. I don't know if you're able to hear that. I need to take a ride somewhere here. These small potholes is something that we need to avoid in street bikes, otherwise the rims are gonna bend. I need to go from there, yeah. What? This is one reason you need an adventure tourer in India, because if you're doing like high speeds and if there's a sudden bump or sudden you know pothole, your Street Fighter is gonna take a big beating. Adventure tourers are gonna take care of it. If you're doing like 120-130, the suspension setup is such that you have long travel suspension and it will smooth it out. But obviously this is not for touring. No, the reason I'm telling you this is people ask me generally, can we buy a Duke 390 or Duke 790 for touring? You can definitely do that, but you have to be a little bit careful, especially on Indian roads, because you don't know when the bumps are gonna come up. Okay, we have a little bit of guards here. Let's try twisting it a little bit. I mean, roads are not that great, as you can see. It's very difficult to tell how the power is on this bike, because sometimes it comes up, it blows out, and sometimes it's a little bit linear. I think all that is solved in the Duke 890. It flies here. Definitely flies. Okay, so I was telling you before that if you're doing like 3000-4000 RPM, that is the point where you're getting a lot of power, right? But then if you're in a different gear, like second gear, I feel, my personal feeling right now, if I pull it, sometimes in third gear it's pulling like mad, and in the first and second gear, again it's a little bit different. It's difficult to explain, you know, when you ride you'll understand. And you see a little bit of, you see that vibration that is there, but that sound is gonna justify everything. You know, that exhaust note is gonna justify every damn thing. So let me take a U-turn now, go back, and I'm hungry. Yeah, we all got our tiffin boxes. We're not gonna eat out. That's a wheelie, yeah. That's a wheelie. You know what is the best part about this bike? You are like, I mean, it's so light. You just feel like you're riding a Duke 390. Look at this dash. I can tell you that this is a Duke 390. This is a Duke 390 looking at all of this. It's so tiny and small and compact, but then it's got a monster inside, 790cc. I really love this speed twin ka sound in the classics. This sounds exactly like that. I mean the thump, it is like that. See that, man. Very nimble. Obviously, like I told you, it's lightweight. It's almost a little bit heavier than the Duke 390. Very little. Marginal difference. I think 7 or 8 kilos of a difference. I'm not sure about the specs and all that. What else? Yeah, these are the first impressions. Balance is good. It's very nimble. So yeah, pretty good bike. It's definitely got that style. What else do you need? And the pricing is also much, much, much better than the Street Triple, if you're considering both of these bikes. Did I miss these people somewhere? Shit. That sound is insane, yeah. Okay. This is the left. Oh. Did I take the right, left? I mean, right gully. Amazing, yeah, loved it. But my personal preference, I would still pick the street triple. Of course, if budget is not a concern, street triple.
Hi, good, good. Now she clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. She does all this. See, clap, clap, clap. Good, good, good. Very good. You want to play? You keep playing. I need to finish my work, okay? Everyone is very busy at home. Some guests are coming. Some guests, my friends are coming for lunch. And so talking about this 790, first when I rode it, I had all this nice... Hi. So when I rode this bike first, I had this nice experience. You play, okay? 2 minutes. In simple terms, if you ask me what is the rating of the bike, I will give it in terms of performance and especially braking. Braking was good, it's decent. Especially when I'm comparing it to my bike, the Tiger, it's not comparable, but then I'm talking about only braking. It is definitely good. But if you compare it to the other bikes we have, the Ducati, Multistrada and the Thruxton, sorry for all that, can't help it. Street Triple, Speedtwin. It's not comparable. Those bikes have like crazy amazing braking. If I give them like 9.5 out of 10 for braking, this one I'll give it 6.5. That is something that can be improved. I think it is improved on the 890 or even the latest 2020 790 Duke. Like I told you, comparing it to the Tiger, it is definitely much better than the braking. But then when my friends rode it, they told me it is horrible braking part. Sorry, she'll be in the frame. Don't mind it. You're disturbing the audience. If you give me a budget of 12 lakhs and ask me to go to the market and buy a bike today in this category, Street Fighter Naked category, I'll definitely blindly go for the Street Triple, especially the RS. Because the race feeling, the sound, the exhaust note, the response, and a little bit of that premium feel, KTM doesn't have it. And I mean, if you feel offended, I can't help it. This is, are you like trying to make fun of me? That is what I felt about the bike. KTMs, generally they concentrate more on power and the functionality of the bike and not about the premium feel. Triumph, on the other hand, they concentrate more on premium and also the functionality. But still, like I always say, in case you guys wanted to get a new Street Fighter for yourself, and if you want to, okay, done, almost done. If you want to get a new bike for yourself in this category, I think you have to consider both. Go test ride both of them. Don't take my words or any other review, like I always say. Go test ride both back to back and then decide which bike to go for. If you ask me, still I might be a little bit convinced about the Duke 790 because oh shit. Okay. I can still be convinced about the Duke 790, but then if you talk to my friends Rohit and Sujan, they definitely don't like it. They're like, okay. Finally, like I told you, it's your call. Go ahead, test it both and come to a conclusion. Naisho, say bye. We don't have an outro, but say bye-bye, okay? Bye-bye. Subscribe, Bull. Please subscribe, like, share, comment. Also, I would like to add that the filtering ability, all that is like really good. I would rate all that on the whole around 8.5 out of 10. That's all excellent. Like its cousin, 390. Yeah, you're coming, Naisho. 1 second. Coming. I might sound a little bit biased, but I'm not biased. This is what I felt about the bike. You people can test ride both of them and you people tell me if I'm wrong. There's a big budget difference, I think almost 1.5-2 lakhs of a difference or maybe more. So in the end of the day, it's your call.